I'm joined by a very special guest. The sounds of silence in the valley effectively mean that voices from the valley are not heard. Whether Mumbai in particular likes it or not, just imagine Mumbai 45 days with no mobile connectivity. This city would collapse, as would the rest of the country. That's exactly what's happened in the Kashmir Valley, for the right or wrong reasons. I'm joined by a very special guest. Iltija Mufti is the daughter of Mehbooba Mufti. Her mother was chief minister, her grandfather was chief minister. And you, Iltija, in a sense, therefore, are seen as the legacy of what the government of India says are the dynasties that destroyed Kashmir.
That helps justify whatever they're doing. I believe you have Piyush Goyal Saab who's going to be speaking here.
Yes.
So Piyush Goyal Saab's father, Ved Goyal Saab, was also the treasurer for BJP, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
And I think he's the same gentleman who mistook Newton for Einstein. So in his case, you could say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. And then you have loads of dynastic families like the Badals, the Thackerays that the BJP supports. So I think this is something very convenient for them as a narrative to push and to discredit my family.
Did you, i.e. the Muftis and the Abdullahs, destroy Kashmir?
Did we destroy Kashmir?
Yeah, the government says that y'all are the reason why Kashmir is where it is. One of the reasons, or one of the main reasons, is that these families monopolized power, and that is why Kashmir is in the situation that it is. How do you respond every time you hear that on television or hear different government representatives say that?
Can I just request first, I have a couple of slides that I need to start.
Sure. There are a couple of slides I think that Siddhi wants to put up.
Yeah.
Okay.
So basically, you know, with this whole narrative around Kashmir, every time I'm on Twitter, Kashmiri young boys and girls are told, you know, you're stone pelters, you're terrorists, and that's how they're seen, unfortunately. So I stayed up last night, and basically these are young Kashmiri boys, girls, you know, men, women who've achieved a lot in their lives, photojournalists, social entrepreneurs, educationists, and I just want everybody here to understand that every Kashmiri is not a potential stone pelter or a terrorist. We're like the rest of you. We have aspirations, and we are inspired by perhaps the same things that you're inspired by. So, you know, I just wanted these slides to play at the same time as we speak.
No, I take those points. I'm looking through some of them, but there is this perception.
Yeah.
Let's be honest. The fact is Kashmir has experienced 3 decades of violence.
Yeah.
Mumbai hasn't, no other part of India has.
Yeah.
So when we refer to the fact that there is today a lockdown, that there is no mobile connectivity, the government will point down that's because Kashmir is today sui generis. It's a different situation. And therefore, the lockdown was necessary to ensure that the situation didn't spiral out of control. It was necessary to put your mother in preventive detention because otherwise she, Omar Abdullah, Farooq Abdullah could go out and make public speeches and it could lead to violence.
So the reason why they arrested my mother and Omar Saab and Farooq Saab is they call it preventive detention,
yes,
like just to ensure that things don't get out of control. I just want to know that all the lynchings that have happened, how many people have been arrested? Have you ever put them in under preventive detention? Haryana is known as, unfortunately, as the rape capital of India, am I right? And there are lots of cases of sexual assault, rapes that happen in that state. Are you telling me that you're going to put all the Haryanvi men behind bars because they could potentially be rapists? I mean, is that your law, that you infringe upon an individual's civil liberties and rights because you preempt what he's going to do? Are you allowed to do that, Rajdeep? Is that... Can you justify that for their detention?
No, look, at the end of the day, again, I come back to it. Kashmir is different.
Yeah.
You know, you have had a low-cost militancy insurgency going on for the last 29 years, fueled by the neighbor from across the border. Therefore, the government believes that it cannot afford to create a situation tomorrow where if there is no clampdown and militancy once again spirals out of control. So there is a fear factor that the government says is the reason why your mother or indeed Omar Abdullah or Farooq Abdullah have been put under detention.
Well, I think you first asked me about family rule, right? So I want to ask you, how does a family rule? They have to be in power, right? They have to be in power. They have to be elected. I can speak for the Mufti family. My grandfather has been the chief minister for 3 years, 4 years of his life, and my mother hardly 2 years. So when they sell that narrative, Muftis and Abdullahs, I don't understand where it's coming from. I mean, they should have had to be in power to rule the state or to be corrupt, right? So why are they peddling this fake narrative, and why don't you even direct questions at them when they talk about it?
You know, you're showing me this team, and this is a wonderful story.
Yeah.
Because an old colleague of mine runs this team. He's a Kashmiri Muslim, and his partner is a Kashmiri Pandit. So if you ever want to know what is possible in India, just look at Real Kashmir. It's a football team that has just defeated the likes of the mighty Mohan Bagan and East Bengal. So why can't we have more Real Kashmirs? That's the question I want to ask you. It is my friend who's a journalist who's made this team, not the politicians, not your mother, not Omar Abdullah, not Farooq Abdullah. The people of Kashmir made Real Kashmir. Government is saying, we're going to create 1,000 Real Kashmirs. We're going to make Kashmir bloom again. Now that Article 3...
Wait, can I interject?
Yes.
Kashmiris have been caged for the past 2 months. You keep talking about the future. Can we talk about now, Rajdeep? Can we talk about the humanitarian crisis? Can we talk about the economic crisis? Can we talk about the psychological crisis? Can we talk about the trauma that you're subjecting people to? Can we talk about the constitutional harakiri that BJP has done? Can we talk about the constitutional desecration that they've done, the illegal, undemocratic manner in which this entire dubious process was carried out? I mean, I'm only hearing about this is for the benefit of Kashmiris. If I'm doing something for your benefit, do you not have that right? Are you not entitled to that right? Where in a, you know, in a civil society where you have a debate, where you talk about if it's good for you, if it's acceptable to you. I mean, if this decision was, Kashmiris are part of this process, right? You didn't even consult them. So how can you justify it by selling them dreams of the future?
You say there is a health economic crisis at the moment. Are you telling me that Kashmiris are, in a sense, angry today because of what's happened? Are you telling me that they're not willing to give the government of India a chance to perhaps try and break the status quo that's existed over the last couple of decades? Try something new.
Try something new that starts with betrayal of their trust. Do you know the manner in which this was done? People were told that, you know, we're expecting an attack from Pakistan, and that's why the yatris were driven out. We had such an amazing tourist season happening. According to the government's own admission, I have to say terrorism happens according to their convenience. So last year, after governor's rule was imposed for a year, they said, oh, everything is fine in the valley. There's no stone pelting. There's no terrorism. There's no infiltration. Now, all of a sudden, there's terrorism. There's infiltration. There's stone pelting. I mean, you guys paint Kashmiris as devils, you know, you paint them as subhuman people. All they want to do is come out and pelt stones. All of a sudden, in the past month and a half, Kashmiris are suddenly peace-loving. So you people also are responsible. The media is responsible. Look at the way you distort the ground reality, Rajdeep. Is it fair to Kashmiris?
You know, you're going on saying you people.
I hold the media responsible as well.
You hold the media responsible?
Yes.
For all that's gone wrong in Kashmir
over the last
few decades?
Not for all that's gone wrong, but I say the coverage, I mean, it's shameful. Look at a BBC, look at Al Jazeera. I met my mother, I met lots of people in Kashmir, and they all said that, oh, you know what? I'm sorry, but India Today, Republic, they're all being slotted in the same category, and they're like, they're so angry that you're not even projecting the ground realities, Rajdeep.
India Today is giving you a platform that none of these other channels, Iltija, would give you. Let me be very clear. In a sense, therefore, it would be unfair for you to lump us with the others. I hold no brief for my profession anymore. There are lots of rotten apples. I hold no brief. There are lots and lots of rotten apples in my profession. But I think it takes a lot that we had Jitender Singh, the minister, and you, and this audience is willing to hear both of you.
Yes.
And that's the way India should be.
Yes.
That we should hear you and the other side. Do you believe it's possible to start that conversation? Or do you believe the betrayal, the word you used, is so great now that even a conversation is not possible anymore?
Rajdeep, how will a conversation be possible? 9 lakh troops are deployed in Kashmir right now. There's no mobile communication. People are completely cut off from each other. You're treating them as subhumans. I mean, this curfew has been going on for 2 months. Where will dialogue even start? You keep getting Pakistan into it when you're at the UN and, you know, when they put you on the spot about possible human rights violations. You say Pakistan needs to stay out. You know, Kashmir is an internal matter. Then the NSA comes to Kashmir or he briefs the media in Delhi. And what does he say? He says that, you know, restrictions are contingent on the behavior of Pakistan. I mean, are you going to hold 9 million people hostage to what Pakistan does? And why do you keep like going back and forth? One of your news anchors did a show the other day and it was about how you guys will, you know, how India will reclaim POK. Then why did you ask them to for permission to enter the airspace? Weren't you snubbed by them? I mean, what is this? It's riddled with contradictions, their approach, Rajdeep.
You know, the audience is also transfixed by some of the examples that you've got. These are all wonderful Kashmir success stories. But I just want to, you know, and I think we should have more of them and we should be showing many more of these success stories. I'm glad you put
There are actually many, many more of them. I stayed up till 3 and then I just thought to myself, I said, if I have to add more, I'm not coming for the conclave this year. So then I just called it a night at 3 and, you know, this is, I ended up with these.
Now,
achievers.
Because, you know, there are many people who believe Article 370 was a stumbling block. It was a stumbling block to the integration of Kashmir with the rest of the country. It was a stumbling block for women. Many believe that Article 370 provisions of it are anti-women. Do you agree with that? That some of the provisions of the law as it existed, A, prevented the development of Kashmir. Outsiders could not, for example, invest or buy in Kashmir. That amongst women, when it came to marital status, there were divergences. Do you believe that Article 370 was a stumbling block?
You know, the government says that Article 370 is a stumbling block, right? And they say that it'll pave the way for development. In 2014, we were told, Achhe din will come. Aa gaye achhe din? Aaye abhi tak? Have they come? Because I'm waiting. And it feels like we've been waiting for a century now. BJP rule states like UP, Bihar, they have such bad socio-economic indicators, which by the way, Kashmir has really good, it's placed really well on the socio-economic parameters. How do you explain development not happening in a state like UP? How do you explain lack of development in Bihar? Article 370 has nothing to do with development, Rajdeep. This is something that they need to show ki 100 din mein humne kya kiya, abrogate kar diya. Economy, GDP is at 5%. A country like Bangladesh has overtaken us. So it's just an excuse. You speak about women development. Kashmiri women are much more emancipated than women anywhere in the rest of the world. Our infant mortality rate, our maternal mortality rates are much, you know, lower than any of the other states. And you talk about emancipation of women. What have BJP ministers been saying ki ab hum yahan sex ratio kam tha to ab hum, you know, we'll get Kashmiri daughter-in-laws? I mean, this sounds like a colonial project. I mean, excuse my language, but it really sounds like a colonial project where you say that, you know, this colony, they are barbaric. They don't deserve democratic freedom. They don't deserve civil liberty. So we'll deprive them of this. We'll see how their behavior is. Agar achha behave karenge, toh de denge. I mean, what are we? Is Kashmir a colony? Is Jammu and Kashmir a colony of India, the way they've behaved?
Now, are you telling me that you believe today, I know you said it to me before the program as well, that you believe we are being pushed into a situation like Tibet?
Yes.
Is in the context of China?
Yes.
I know that others have spoken about Gaza and Palestine. Are these overreactions? Do you believe that the Indian state shouldn't be given a fair chance? Is it fair on your part 45 days after the clampdown to suggest that Kashmir will be like Tibet or Kashmir will be like Gaza?
Rajdeep, this is not just my opinion. I think this is a common sentiment that's echoed by all of Kashmir. And because of this clampdown, there are all kinds of rumors. Kashmir has become like a breeding ground for rumors. There's a rumor about how the government of India has consulted Israeli intelligence. They've mapped the entire city. And, you know, they know exactly what's going on. And Kashmiris feel that Kashmir will be turned into a ghetto. अभी खुद देखिए उनको कर्फ्यू पास चाहिए अपने स्टेट में आप लोग बॉम्बे में अगर आपको अपने स्टेट में ट्रैवल करने के लिए कर्फ्यू पास चाहिए होगा हाउ विल यू गाइस फील कैन यू इमेजिन लाइक देयर इज नो सेंस ऑफ नॉर्मलसी देयर राजदीप आई मीन हाउ डज दिस वर्क
आर यू टेलिंग मी देयरफॉर दैट यू बिलीव द लास्ट 45 डेज हैव ओनली वाइडन्ड द गैप मेंटली not just physically, but mentally, between the average Kashmiri and the average person outside Kashmir?
Of course they have. I mean, Kashmiris feel that their sense of identity, their sense of culture is going to be subsumed. And they feel that this is a concerted propaganda on the part of the Indian government. I mean, honestly, you have leaders who talk about the unfinished business of partition. Aapko kya, do you want to punish minorities now? Do you want to persecute minorities for unfinished business of partition? What is this logic, Rajdeep?
But let's be honest, Iltija, there have been mistakes made, numerous mistakes. Elections were rigged. You've had a situation where Kashmiri pandits were driven out of the valley. You've had a situation where, as I said, you've had 29 years of consistent violence. Lots of innocent lives, mainly Kashmiri Muslims, have died because of militancy. Maybe the time has come that the government of India is saying enough is enough. We want
enough is enough. So let's take state. Let's institutionalize repression and let's use brute force. Is that how you're going to win over hearts? I mean, what is the theme here, Rajdeep? How do you win over hearts? Do you win over hearts through brute force?
So you tell me. You tell me, how do you win over hearts? Let's look at that.
Well, certainly not by...
How do you win over hearts and minds? How do you win over?
Certainly not by what they've done. I mean, if you want to win the confidence of Kashmiri people, then you have to roll back. I'm sorry, but you're going to have to roll back this because it's only driven... It's increased the sense of alienation that Kashmiris have towards the rest of the country. You know, every media person asks me, aapko kaisa lagta hai, mainstream has been discredited. You're asking me the wrong question. Look at the India that we're in. Is this Gandhi's India or is this Godse's India? I mean, this is an India which would pride itself on secularism, on its democratic ethos. We're hurtling towards an authoritarian regime, Rajdeep. This doesn't feel like a democracy anymore. I don't feel like I have any civil liberties, I have any rights. And how long will you keep using Kashmir as a red herring? Aapki economy niche ja rahi hai. You can't buy a 5 rupee Parle G biscuit, innerwear, FMCG products, automobiles. There's a slump in everything. Aapka jawab kya hai har ek cheez ke liye? Bharat Mata ki jai. Jai Shri Ram. Abrogation of Article 370. Is this the solution to all our problems, Rajdeep, that you use Kashmir to divert everybody's attention?
You're still not providing me the answer to the question I asked. How do you win over hearts and minds?
By reaching out to them, by treating them like human beings. Do you know, Rajdeep, in Rajasthan, a 24-year-old student, Faiz Mir, he was harassed. He was made to dress up as a woman. How is everybody's behavior towards Kashmiris right now? They're being looked at with suspicion. Aise thodi na jeette hain hearts and minds. Pehle at least start treating them like a human being. I mean, what is this that, you know, they're all stone pelters or they're all terrorists? I mean, look at the way you view Kashmiris, Rajdeep. There's no one-line answer to how to win hearts and minds. First of all, you've betrayed their trust. You've gone behind their back. They feel like they've been stabbed in the back. The manner in which this was done, it's been completely unconstitutional. How can you win over hearts when you've stabbed them in the back? Abhi aapne itna wound inflict ki aap mujhse pooch rahe ho, marham kya lagega? How can I tell you?
You know, these are all very... You know, these are very strong words, and I respect your view to I respect your views. But today, if I had a Kashmiri pandit in the audience, they may well turn around and say, Iltija, where were you when we were driven out of the valley? This is the narrative.
I was 2 years old.
I know you were 2 years old. What I'm saying is, where was this Kashmiri voice that you're strongly speaking about insaniyat, about notions of bringing people together, about Kashmiriyat.
Rajdeep.
I just wonder whether have we reached a stage where it's impossible to bridge hearts and minds because the mistrust is so great. Is it possible, like my friend has built this Real Kashmir football team, that a Kashmiri pandit and a Kashmiri Muslim can come together and build something for the future? Do you really see that happening?
Not in the near future, I don't. I mean, Kashmiris feel a deep sense of shock and betrayal. I don't know how you're going to undo the damage and the pain that you've inflicted on Kashmiri. And when I keep saying Kashmir, I just don't mean Kashmir. Even people of Kargil are not happy. They've been protesting. People of Jammu also have apprehensions about abrogation of Article 370, 35A. You see, for the people of Jammu and Kashmir, it's a fight for their land. It's a fight for their culture. It's a fight for their sense of identity. They feel that they're in for demographic changes. They feel that BJP is using using this as a shield. Development, women emancipation is a shield. What they want to do is engineer demographic changes, and what better place to start than to start with the only Muslim majority state that that India has.
There are two trends, would you agree, though, that are there. There is the trend of the Islamization, in a sense, of the valley. And there is what you could call the Hindutva mindset, which perhaps looks at a Muslim majority state with suspicion. I sometimes wonder what is the where is the solution? If one side believes that there is Islamization is the way forward, a certain radicalization, and the other side says, no, Hindutva will prevail. You will have to accept one nation, one constitution. Can't have a separate status for Kashmir.
Why? Nagaland has its own flag. Nagaland has its own national anthem. There are federal arrangements that the government of India has with other states where they have special provisions. In Maharashtra, we're in Maharashtra right now. Shiv Sena keeps saying give Maharashtrians preferential treatment. Unka chalta hai, hamara nahi chalta. We still have a background of partition. We acceded to India on these terms. Why can't we be entitled to these same privileges, Rajdeep? Tell me.
Why can't you be...
You know, Kamal Nath in Madhya Pradesh... he passed a bill which spoke about 70% reservation of jobs for locals. Your Andhra Pradesh CM, Jagan Reddy, right? One of the first things that he did was he passed a bill for reservation. Baki karte hain to theek hai, Kashmiri karte hain to terrorist stone pelter ban jate hain. Kyun?
Kyunki itihas aapka kuch alag hai. You see, the problem ye hai, because, and I didn't say that for claps. You know my views on this. It's a fraught history. It's a history which is fraught in the partition project. It's a history whether you like
when
it or
you,
not.
When you say itihas alag hai, what do you mean?
You know, we saw the manner in which the accession of Kashmir took place. Mm-hmm. Pakistan has never fully accepted it. You fought 3-4 wars over it, India and Pakistan. Lalu Prasad once told me, in Pakistan, Kashmir is like the bell, which India and Pakistan are pulling the horns on either side, and the bell is dying. The buffalo is dying. I thought it was a great analogy.
It is.
Because at one level, Kashmir is a frozen turbulence, a bloodied land. I'm looking for solutions. So when you compare Kashmir to Andhra, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, it's not quite the same. There is no Pakistan sending infiltrators or terrorists into Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra.
Rajdeep, I am not comparing. I'm saying that you guys have double standards. There are states, there are northeastern states that have special constitutional provisions. You cannot buy land in these states. The Nagaland just celebrated its own national, Independence Day and everything. What is this double standard? If Kashmiris feel threatened, aap mujhe khud bataiye, is country mein kitni lynchings hui hain, Rajdeep? How many of those people have been sent to jail? Jail mein kaun se log hain aajkal? Sudha Bhardwaj, a lawyer who fights for human rights. Sanjeev Bhatt, that inspector in Gujarat, who is outside? That Swami guy today, they've just taken him in.
He's been arrested.
These
today.
People are out. Huh? This is the state of our country, that people who fight for, you know, who fight for rights are inside, and the ones jo uksa rahe hain, Sadhvi Pragya, who was elected, she called Godse, who assassinated Mahatma Gandhi, a patriot. She's out and about. You know, today I feel a sense of pride my mother is arrested. That surely means she's standing up for something that's right. Please look at the people who are in, and please look at the people who are out.
You have a career in politics.
Please don't say that.
It probably, no, but look, I can see where you're coming from. And I can appreciate that as a Kashmiri, you feel the angst. The challenge that is what is the solution? You've seen Pakistan's response. You know, you have leaders, responsible Rajdeep. Leaders, including the Prime Minister, talk of a nuclear war. I just wonder, therefore, you know, what is the solution? What is the, is lifting of the clampdown really going to resolve the issue tomorrow? Come tomorrow, will suddenly peace return to the valley? I just wonder, there are no quick fix solutions, surely.
Rajdeep, tell me one thing. The people of my state, the leadership of my state, acceded to India or Pakistan? Just answer me. India or Pakistan? Who abrogated Article 370? India or Pakistan? Aap har ek cheez ke liye Kashmiri ko Pakistan ka taana dete hain. If I talk about Kashmir, I am derided as a Pakistani sympathizer, anti-India. I mean, what is this? Like, How long will you keep using the Pakistani card, Rajdeep? How long will you keep punishing Kashmiris? Until last year, the Indian government said ki humne governors rule kiya, sab kuch theek ho gaya, infiltration down ho gaya, stone pelting nahi ho rahi. Ab achanak se again you're bringing Pakistan into the narrative. Isn't that a matter of convenience for you, for the government?
You showed me these wonderful images and stories of Kashmiris who've been success stories. We also spoke of the stone pelters. How do you see the stone pelters? Your mother would call them misguided youth.
Yes.
And many believe that that was almost rationalizing, excusing the kind of attacks that they would have on our security forces. How do you, you know, between these success stories and between the stone pelters, who do you think are the role models for the Kashmiris of tomorrow?
Rajdeep, do you know that most of the youngsters who are gravitating towards militancy, do you know most of them are PhD students, some of them are engineering students? So you can't paint everyone with the same brush. Aapke dimag mein ek image aati hai, stone pelter, jahil hai, anpad hai, gawar hai. These people see so much. Do you know Burhan Wani became a militant because he was picked up by the army or the paramilitary forces? So a lot of things have happened to these people. Koi pagal nahi hai ki wo achanak se patthar utha ke phekta hai. I'm not justifying it. I'm just trying to humanize them. You see, the government of India has this concerted propaganda where they've dehumanized Kashmiris today, Rajdeep. There is no collective conscience of this nation. Inko matlab aap logon ko ehsaas nahi hota ki Kashmiris have been like this for the past 2 months. You showed more collective outrage and you were more upset when that Chandrayaan moon, what was it, a rover, right? You showed more feelings when it failed. Yahan pe 9 million people are incarcerated. Do you not feel empathy for them?
No, I feel empathy for the Kashmiri. I'm just saying that let's assume tomorrow the government lifts the clampdown. Is the problem going to be resolved?
Well, they've created a problem, so you can ask them for a solution. It wasn't our suggestion to them ki aap Article 370 abrogate kare na. This is a problem that's self-inflicted. I've said this before as well. It's a self-goal. You've played into the hands of terrorists. You've possibly even played into the hands of Pakistan. Aap Pakistan, Pakistan bolte rehte hain. It's so embarrassing on the international forum. You have Pakistan speaking up for Kashmiris. What is India doing?
What does the average Kashmiri want in your view today? Does he want to reject both these countries today? Are you telling me that the average Kashmiri wants...
Well, the average Kashmiri, I know this is going to land me into a lot of trouble, but the average Kashmiri views India as an occupational force. They're not even thinking about Pakistan. They want freedom. There, I said it. But it's the truth.
Are you speaking for a small elite of Gupkar Road and those who live in Mausua?
The small elite of Gupkar Road actually wanted to participate in the political process. What did you do to them, Rajdeep? Farooq Saab, jinke walid ne two nation theory reject ki, unpe aapne PSA slap kar diya raat ke 1 baje. Pichle saal Vajpayee ji ka function hua tha, wahan pe he chanted Jai Hind. Do you know he was heckled at a congregational prayer in Hazratbal Mosque? People almost attacked him. What have you done to that man? Do you know how old he is, Rajdeep? Do you know he's ailing? How have you treated him? On charges of what? Corruption?
It's interesting to see the Muftis and the Abdullahs come together.
I'm a human first. I am a human first.
Sure.
And then I'm a Mufti and then I'm a Kashmiri. And if we all want to be good, you can be a good Hindu, Muslim, but pehle insaan ke bacche to ban jao. Main insaan ki bachchi hoon. That's why I empathize with him, Rajdeep.
Look, Atal Bihari Vajpayee famously spoke about Kashmiriyat, Jamhuriyat, Insaniyat. Where has been insan?
That's the irony. That's the irony that BJP is following in the missteps of Congress and not in the steps of BJP. Look at how Vajpayee Saab conducted himself. Kashmiris, if they've looked up to one leader, if they've had respect for one Indian, like, you know, national leader, it's been Vajpayee ji. BJP had a roadmap. What did they do? Congress ko itna criticize karte hai, emergency. Khud aapne emergency declare kar di Kashmir mein.
But let's be honest. And we're, you know, where is Jamhuriyat when only 10-15% people vote the remaining boycott? Where is Insaniyat?
Boycott kyun karte hai?
Where is Insaniyat when you have, as I said, gave the example of the Kashmiri Pandits who were driven out of the valley? Where is the notion of Kashmiriyat? And this is again linked to the Pandits. You know, the whole idea of a melting pot, Sufism. Let's be honest, these are all romantic notions. But there is a reality on the ground. Much of what you say, I have full empathy,
Rajdeep,
for the Kashmiri.
Rajdeep, do you think we haven't suffered, Rajdeep? As a teenager, I've seen my mother walk out of the door in a battered Ambassador. And I didn't even know if she's going to come back home to me in the evening. And this is probably when I was a child. I think I was 10 or 11. Now when I think of it, I normalized it, you know. For me, it was like, okay, she's going, she might not. Terrorism is not something that's just affected pandits, Rajdeep. It's not a virus ki bas unko hua aur hume nahi hua. How much have we lost, Rajdeep, because the pandits had to leave? I mean, Kashmir is a much richer place with pandits. We want them to come back. Aap log aisa kyun sochte hain ki hum musalman hain to hume fark hi nahi pada hai, Rajdeep? There's not a single life there that hasn't been, you know, affected by the insurgency. Even it's had an impact on everybody to just say this ki indirectly hint ki, you know, theek hai, Kashmiriyat isliye nahi hai because pandits were driven out and we supported it. We never supported it, Rajdeep.
No, I take it. 90% of those who've died, and even more possibly, are local Kashmiris. You know, I feel sorriest for the Jammu and Kashmir police. They have been caught really in this battle like no one else. And many of them I know are brave, very brave officers who've got caught in a battle. I want to ask you though at the end, you've spoken of the human factor. You've given us all these heroes for the future. What, in your view, is the one thing that you would like to see happen in Kashmir today? What's that one thing that would give you hope? Because listening to you, I feel depressed. You know,
I'm coming from a state that's seen a clampdown for the past 2 months where people are being repressed. It's unimaginable repression. Do you want me to be bursting firecrackers here on your stage? I mean, I feel the pain of my people. My mother's been incarcerated. Of course, I'm going to not have a very positive outlook. They've treated us like a herd of cattle, Rajdeep. They haven't even treated us as human beings. Am I supposed to do somersaults here?
Are you not going to give the Indian government a chance? Aren't you willing to say that, look, maybe we need to reach out?
Are they reaching out? I mean, I saw pictures of Modi Saab, a belated happy birthday to him. I'm told that he celebrated his 69th birthday. But the two images that stayed with me was, one was a very sweet one of him and his mother having thalis on the table. And I said to myself, Modi Saab, abhi 10-11 साल के बच्चे हैं जिनको अगवा कर दिया गया है उनकी माओं को रात को नींद भी नहीं आती होगी ये सोते हुए कि उनका बच्चा कहाँ पे है। I mean, आप अपनी मदर से मिल सकते हैं हमें हक नहीं है क्या मुझे हक नहीं है कि अपनी माँ से मिलने का मुझे क्यों सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पास जाना पड़ा मोदी जी डोंट वी हैव द राइट एंड आई सॉ दिस अदर शॉट विच वॉज कैरिड बाई द मीडिया एज वेल वेयर ही रिलीज दीज बटरफ्लाइज आप बटरफ्लाइज को फ्रीडम दे रहे हैं अब कश्मीरियों को भी कुछ हम भी तो इंसान है ना We deserve freedom, right?
Okay. You've had the freedom to speak. And as I said earlier to you, when you were attacking the entire media, I don't know how many...
I'm here for you and I'm here for Arun Puri Saab.
Good.
I didn't paint India Today completely bad, but you are what redeems this channel. I'll say it again.
No, but the fact is, at the end of the day, my worry is that we live in an era where we demonize each other.
Yeah.
I don't want to demonize the Kashmiri. And I don't think you should demonize the media. We need to find a new compact because that's the only way. I believe that Kashmir has huge potential and nothing would please me better than Kashmir. Many more real Kashmiris blooming. I wish you well and I hope that next year, this time, we'll have a rather happier conversation.
I hope so. I want to end with a few lines which were written by Faiz, the poet. दिल ना उम्मीद तो नहीं ना काम ही तो है लंबी है गम की शाम मगर शाम ही तो है सो वी होप दैट दिस टिरनी दैट्स बीन अनलीस्ड ऑन अस एट सम पॉइंट थिंग्स आर गोना चेंज एंड इंशाल्लाह कश्मीर इज गोना हैव अ ब्राइट फ्यूचर थैंक यू फॉर हैविंग मी हियर
यू रोट फेयर्स ऑन योर पाम
यस
ओके ग्रेट थैंक यू ऑल वेरी मच लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन इल्तिजा मुफ्ती द अदर वॉइस दैट वी वांटेड टू हियर हियर एट द इंडिया टुडे कॉन्क्लेव थैंक यू वेरी मच